Mr. Speaker, New Brunswick has worked really hard and really came together since the pandemic began. But there's been some negative impacts in the province as well. Vaccine mandates has been a very contentious issue, which everyone feels very strongly on either side, and it has caused a lot of friction amongst people. I get a lot of calls from people sharing completely different views on what they feel is right for vaccine mandates. Some feel vaccines should be mandated and are concerned for unvaccinated workers that are looking after our seniors and our children and putting them at risk. Others just don't trust the safety of this new vaccine, feels that it is still experimental stages, but cannot afford to be put off work without pay because of a personal choice they feel they have the right to make. But everyone shares the same concern, wondering what is going to happen to the services in New Brunswick after November the 19th. People on both sides of this issue have the right to their beliefs, and everyone should be open and accepting of that. But at the end of the day, when this mandate is dropped on November 19th, it's going to put a real strain on our system that we really cannot afford to have. Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Mr. Speaker, staff shortages in New Brunswick have been an issue for some time, and especially in our health care, and now that the pandemic has completely heightened that. With the new vaccine mandate coming up on November 19th, I've had many calls from workers that are not going to be able to work. And these people are not anti-vaxxers. Some are nurses and paramedics. They are citizens who are generally concerned of the risks with the vaccine and feel they should be able to be tested and still go to work. Considering we are critically short-staffed, as it is, and we cannot lose any workers, we know your deadline is coming up, and we have seen Quebec and Ontario have abandoned the vaccine mandates. So my question is for the Premier, can you tell us what is coming up for November 19th? Will you haul back on the vaccine mandates for workers, or will you go through with it? And if you do, what are your plans to keep our services and our hospitals and our surgeries going forward?
The Minister of Health.
Thank you very much, Mr. Speaker, for the question. We're aware of the Quebec and Ontario decisions. I have to emphasize that we have seen what happens when the vaccine gets into our hospitals, gets into our long-term care sectors. It is a very difficult time. And we know that the best way to prevent that is through vaccination. So, Mr. Speaker, we're still working diligently with everyone, those who are resistant to getting their vaccines, trying to use every piece of information we can to suggest that this is our best way. We are reviewing the decisions of our partners in across this country, and staying in touch with medical officers of health throughout. And we won't have a decision on that until in the forthcoming days.